Hello friends, I am Vinay and this is lecture based on vapor compression refrigeration system with wet compression. In my previous video I explained the same topic with TS chart. Now I am explaining with pH chart. The pH chart is separately explained. Please watch the video for pH chart, that is for refrigerant 12. Refrigerant 12 ke liye pH chart pehle hi explain kar chuka hun. Without this system, the basic parameter of pH chart is already explained. Please watch the previous videos. So, in this video, I am explaining the whole process of wet compression with respect to pH chart. So, we will start step by step. This is the model diagram. This is pH chart. So, on y-axis, there is pressure line. On x-axis, there is an enthalpy line. This is the standard curve. This is the standard curve for pH chart. This is critical point, and from critical point this is saturated liquid line, and this from critical point this is saturated vapor line. And in pH chart this is a constant temperature line. Temperature line are moving like this one in this. That's mean this is a constant temperature. If 30 degree Celsius is there, 30 degree Celsius at each and every point of this line. This is temperature line, this is another temperature line, this one is another temperature line. These are constant temperature lines. These are moving like this one. So, these are constant pressure line. This is a constant pressure line. I already explained the pH chart R12 refrigerant in previous videos. Please check. If you are unable to read out the pH chart, you are unable to understand the topic. So this is point number one. At point number one, pressure is P1, and at point number one, this is a constant temperature line. Temperature is T1. This is a constant temperature line. From 1 to 2, there is a compressor. Compressor work on isentropic process. That's mean 1 to 2, entropy is constant. In this chart, pH chart, entropy line in form of curve form. This is inclined lines. So this is inclined line, this is for entropy. From 1 to 2 there is a process isentropic compression. So we have to follow isentropic line. This is isentropic line, S1 is equal to S2. We got point number 2 at another pressure. This is compression process isentropic line. Here we have to follow isentropic line. 1 to 2, due to compression there is increase in pressure and increase in temperature both. Increase in temperature from T1 to T2. Increase in pressure from P1 to P2. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression. The compression process will take place isentropically. 2 to 3, we go to the point number 2. 2 to 3, there is a condenser. 2 to 3, there is a condenser in which heat energy is removed at a constant pressure. 2 to 3, there is a condenser unit which rejects the heat at a constant pressure. So heat is rejected, due to which the vapor molecules are converted into liquid particles. So refrigerant is converted into liquid. It will touch to liquid line. That means this is saturated liquid line. All the molecules at this point are in form of liquid. So this is heat energy is removed in this cycle. Heat energy continuously removed. We got point number 3. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression. 2 to 3 constant pressure heat rejection. After this, from 3 to 4, there is an expansion valve. Isoenthalpic process in expansion valve. Enthalpy is constant in expansion valve. 3 to 4, this is point number 4. 3 to 4, isoenthalpic process. That means enthalpy is constant. 3 to 4. This is 3 to 4 isoenthalpic line. It is a straight line because enthalpy is constant. At point number 3, enthalpy. At point number 4, enthalpy, both points enthalpy is same because it follow the constant enthalpy. At point number 3 and at point number 4, this is point number 4, at both point enthalpy is constant because expansion wall is working on isoenthalpic process. So 3 to 4 enthalpy is constant. 4 to 1, there is an evaporator unit. This is an evaporator unit, 4 to 1, which absorbs the heat energy from the system. That's mean actual refrigerating effect produced in the system in evaporator. work input in compressor. So 4 to 1, it at point number 4, it will absorb the heat energy from the system, and due to absorption of heat, it will convert it into vapor form. 4 point pe liquid particles hai majority mein, wo continuously heat energy absorb karenge system se aur dheere dheere kya honge, convert hote hue chale jayenge vapor form mein. So at point number 1, we got maximum part of vapor particles, refrigerant in vapor form. So 4 to 1 is actual refrigerating effect is produced. That's mean 4 to 1 refrigerating effect is produced by heat absorption. Heat due to heat absorption. The heat is absorbed at a constant pressure in evaporator. Evaporator work on constant pressure, condenser work on a constant pressure, expansion valve isoenthalpic, compressor on isentropic. These are isentropic line, these are isoenthalpic line, these two are constant pressure line. So this is the pH chart, this is the pH chart for vapor compression refrigeration system for wet compression. So we go to the point number, again in this video there is a misprint, isoenthalpic, there is 1 to 2 isentropic compression in compressor, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat rejection in condenser, this is 1 to 2 is wrong feed, this is 3 to 4 isoenthalpic process, 4 to 1 there is constant pressure heat absorption in evaporator. So we will find out the COP, refrigerating effect divided by work input. Refrigerating effect is H1 at point number 1 enthalpy minus H4. This is the refrigerating effect, and this is the work input in compressor. Work input in compressor from 1 to 2. Refrigerating effect is produced from 4 to 1. That's why H1 minus H4 is refrigerating effect. H2 minus H1, H2 enthalpy and H1 enthalpy. H2 minus H1 is our work input. So thank you guys. If you like the video, please press like button. If any query or any problem, please comment on the video and also subscribe the channel. Thank you very much. वतन मेरे वतन.